was only 2,653 days ago.
Winning is everything. It's what every Raider gets up early every morning to train for, to achieve that dream, to taste that success and become a MotoGP winner. And for a very select few, those dreams come true. And for some, they go on to win multiple races, but also some need to wait months, even years, to taste that podium Prosecco again. The victory drought is so long, many riders have come and gone. The bikes are completely different to the one they last won a race on, and in some cases, they've changed teams multiple times.
Petrucci's dream is realised! He is a MotoGP winner at last, and he will tear the roof off Mugello! What a race!
Petruc stole the show at the 2019 Italian Grand Prix.
His first ever MotoGP victory. The crowd go wild, Ducati go wild. Petrucci peerless in Mugello.
From humble beginnings racing Superstock 1000, the Italian progressed through CRT to the Pramac team and found himself in Factory Red. And for his home Grand Prix, put in a display worthy of a place at Ducati, took on the two best riders of that time in a last lap classic.
Marc Marquez hits the front here in Mugello. Has he timed this to absolute perfection? Asking major, major question. The two Ducatis, oh, all three of them almost have contact. Petrucci ran the title line, picked up the Vizioso. He picked up Marc Marquez. And after all that, Petrucci still lead.
However, he would only go on to score one more podium that season and would struggle going into 2020. But once racing got underway again in July of 2020 after the COVID-19 pandemic, Petrucci struggled to break the top 10. However, his star shone bright once again in a damp Le Mans.
Danilo Petrucci has won the French Grand Prix! Second win, he splashed his way to victory here in France.
Maverick Viñales, the 22-year-old Spaniard, on his Yamaha debut, wins here in Qatar.
Maverick Viñales burst out of the gates with Yamaha in 2017, with two wins from the first two races, and looked to be odds-on favourite for the title. But following two tough rounds in Kota and Jerez, he entered Le Mans 2 points behind teammate Valentino Rossi.
What an unbelievable French Grand Prix here in Le Mans.
Little would we know this would be Vinales' final win of the season, as the wheels completely fell off the wagon, as the Spaniard only scored four more podiums, and it wouldn't be until the 2018 Australian GP, a year and a half later, Vinales would have his chance again for victory.
Maverick Vinales wins for Yamaha finally here in Phillip Island. He's been through some real tough and turbulent times, Maverick Vinales. First victory in 29 MotoGP races. Their long losing streak has ended here in Australia.
A year after his title glory, Jorge Lorenzo bowed out of his time with Yamaha with a late to flag a victory in superb Jorge Lorenzo style.
29 years old, three world titles for Yamaha. He signs off for Yamaha to join Ducati with a win here in Valencia.
As the Mallorcan began his journey in Ducati Red, not many would have predicted the struggles the five-time champion would have until the 2018 Italian GP.
Jorge Lorenzo is back! He wins for Ducati here in Mugello!
And that flag flies for the first time in a long time.
Having been told prior to the race weekend he would be replaced for 2019, the Spaniard was ready to show Ducati and the world he still had what it took.
Marquez is the master of 2019 and he wins here in Valencia.
Having wrapped up his 2019 World Championship, Marc Marquez was standing on top of the world and set a new all-time points record and capped off a season where he finished either first or second in every race he finished.
He does it again. The world champion does it here in Japan. It's four in a row. The magic mark.
With eight world championships in his pocket, nothing looked like it would stop Marquez. However, a crash in Jerez, breaking his arm and trying to rush back a week later after surgery, put Marquez out until the 2021 Portuguese Grand Prix.
And the returning Marc Marquez will take that P7.
However, three DNFs followed in the races leading up to his happy hunting ground, Sachsenring, where the 27-year-old had won in his last 10 visits. So, if there was anywhere he could win again, it would be here.
He is back, ladies and gentlemen, and still the King of the Ring. 581 days since his last victory. His 83rd Grand Prix win, his 57th in MotoGP, one that many thought would never happen again. Marc Marquez is back. He is the King of the Sachsenring yet again.
2018 Moto3 World Champion Jorge Martin burst onto the MotoGP scene, and it was little surprise he was immediately fast. Pole positions and podiums, but also some misfortune summed up his rookie season, but in the Styrian Hills for the Styrian GP, he really made his mark.
They don't call him the Martinator for nothing. Jorge Martin is a MotoGP winner here in Styria. Pramac Ducati have their win in MotoGP in the hands of a rookie.
Struggling to get to grips with the 2022 Ducati, Martin struggled in his second season, but after a mixed start to 2023, it was a German Grand Prix where Martin would finally taste top step glory. Once again.
They come on line side by side. Oh, inches in it. How close was that? But it's Jorge Martin who takes a Sachsenring stunner. Martin takes the win by just 0.06 of a second. His first MotoGP win in his last 35 races.
A second MotoGP race winner's trophy to Jorge Martin. He wins a thriller at the Sachsenring.
Both Suzuki riders struggled to qualify on the first two rows for most of 2020, and with Alex Rins starting from 10th on the grid for the Aragon Grand Prix, he was overlooked for a podium challenge. However, an inspired start would set Rins on course for a victory challenge.
A standing victory for Alex Rins here in Aragon. This is 15th Grand Prix victory, his third in MotoGP.
After watching teammate Joan Mir claim title glory in 2020 and having a difficult season in 2021, and with news that Suzuki would pull out of MotoGP at the end of 2022, things were looking grim for Rins in MotoGP. But the Australian Grand Prix would remind the world of the immense talent the Spaniard had.
Rins wins in Australia, an absolute classic. Absolutely brilliant. His first win in 38 Grand Prix.
Valentino Rossi had a torrid 2010, suffering a compound fracture during practice for the Italian Grand Prix. But once he returned, victories eluded him. However, a vintage Rossi performance put him back on the top step for the 46th and, as we thought, the final time for Yamaha.
Valentino Rossi wins the Malaysian Grand Prix. 46 wins now with the factory Yamaha team.
Fast forward 2.5 years and two unsuccessful seasons with Ducati. Rossi had returned to Team Blue for 2013, and as the paddock rolled up to Assen, place of so many victories for the Doctor, could he return to winning ways?
Italy has stopped for 1 minute. Valentino Rossi wins here in Assen. He's back in business.
And victory number 47 for number 46 at Yamaha as well.
106 Grand Prix wins for Valentino Rossi. Rossi wins at Assen. His first Grand Prix victory for 2.5 years.
His return to victory marked 46 races since his Sepang success.
Never, never, never write the Doctor off.
The 2021 Qatar Grand Prix was a vintage display by Maverick Vinales.
Take my breath away, Top Gun! Maverick with a masterclass here in the Middle East.
But after this, he would leave Yamaha mid-season and join Aprilia. It took the Spaniard almost a full year to begin to challenge for podiums with the Nuvoli factory. Glimpses of brilliance were sparse, but with the new RSGP 24 for 2024, Maverick Vinales looked back to his 2017 best, and many were wondering, could he finally be the first rider to win with three different manufacturers in the MotoGP era?
It's magnificent, magic Maverick Vinales, his first Grand Prix victory, fully factory, Aprilia team, first to win with three different manufacturers in the MotoGP era, superhero performance, Batmav forever.
Bypassing Moto2 for 2015 from Moto3 into MotoGP, Jack Miller's first year and a half was tough, but he would show his wet weather prowess in abundance during a very wet and wild 2016 Dutch Grand Prix.
Jack Miller has done it! Jack Miller has won here in Assen!
And Jack Miller celebrates in Jack Miller style, a superb stand-up wheelie from Miller. First MotoGP victory.
For 2021, Miller was promoted to the factory Ducati team after impressing with Pramac for the previous three seasons, and as the closing stages began in the 2021 Spanish Grand Prix, Miller running second started closing down Fabio Quartararo.
Aussie, he's done it! Miller wins in the MotoGP race here in Jerez. Absolutely love it. That's the way to celebrate your first dry MotoGP win. Just the second race-winning trophy to Jack Miller. He is the Wizard of Oz here in Jerez.
It's going to be Andrea Dovizioso who wins the British Grand Prix. Said it all, didn't it? Andrea Dovizioso wins his first Grand Prix. Holds the trophy aloft. Well done, Andrea. Enjoy that one, won't you?
7 years, 3 months and 5 days is how long it took for Andrea Dovizioso to win again after his victory at Donington in 2009.
Andrea Dovizioso, the 30-year-old Italian, wins his first MotoGP race for Ducati, the second of his career.
The Italian had gone from Honda to Tech 3 Yamaha and then to Ducati. And MotoGP had changed from 800cc engines to 1000s. And the sport had gone from Bridgestone to Michelin tyres during that time. But as the rain fell for the 2016 Malaysian Grand Prix, the win looked far from certain.
He wins here at Sepang in Malaysia. 2009, that last Grand Prix victory came for Andrea Dovizioso, the British Grand Prix at Donington Park.
It was only 2,653 days ago.
What's that? You want more? Click here to subscribe.